Alright, hey, what's up, builders? It's your girl, Kantoinette, vlogger, and you are now listening to the LBF Podcast. I am at this awesome live event that was put on by Swash and Sexy, and we are going to be interviewing some business owners and creators in their own right. Beside me, I have Brian Dixon, and he is the owner of Live, Love, and Appreciate. So, Brian, how are you feeling today?
Feeling good.
You said that you did a little bit of travel to come here.
Yeah, I did.
Can you speak on like why you chose to make that decision?
This came from the community. I decided to make that decision in order to network with different people. Because you never know who you might be.
Yeah, that's definitely a good model to go by. Like, we were talking a little bit before this and how a lot of times, sometimes as business owners or creatives, we kind of get stuck in our own way. So it's good to venture out and make those connections. So with your clothing line, what connections are you trying to make?
No connections, just to get it out there, more people that I meet, to get more designs and more ideas as I travel to different vendors and things like that.
Okay, so you say you're originally out of Columbia?
Yes.
Okay. And so, like I said, your business is Live, Love, and Appreciate.
Live, Love, Appreciate.
How long have you been doing this?
I've been doing this since last May.
Okay.
About a year.
So, what inspired you to start?
I just wanted to be an entrepreneur, my own business owner. So, I just thought I'd go ahead and do it. Not wait.
Like that. So, did COVID have anything to do with that?
Being that I got laid off my job, I just went ahead and did it. But I've had the idea before COVID.
No, that's really dope. I think a lot of people became more spirited and creative during that time. So it's awesome that you were able to build something so awesome from it. I'm going to hold up, or I'm going to have you hold up a few of the things I brought for you. So, y'all, like, this is his clothing line, this set that I just brought. And for me, coming up on the fall and winter month, I'm one of those people that I get cute when I get cute. But 9 times out of 10, I'm wearing sweats. So this is like a comfy but cute way to do that. And you can find him on social media. I'll let him say his social media because I don't want to butcher it. So go ahead and plug that for the builder.
Okay, my social media, Facebook, LLAJD, my Instagram, LLA_JD, website, www.LLAshopJD.com.
Awesome. Last question. Where do you want your business to take you?
I want it to take me, like, far as it can. You know, being that I have a son, you know, I want him to come up and seeing that I can do it, he can definitely do it also. So I want it to take me far as it can. I put in the work. Just go down. Generation.
That's so awesome. Brian, thank you so much for coming to talking with us. You have a good one. I'll be back down there at some point.
I do appreciate it. Definitely.
All right, builders, I am here with Ms. Shaquilla. She is the owner of Queen's Legacy LLC. And y'all, she got candles. Okay. Let's talk a little bit about the candles.
Okay. Journey. It was actually a joke. It started off as a joke. My dad was like, "You find so many candles, bro. You gonna say the name?" But I was in the mall always buying candles. He was like, "You should learn how to make your own." And I was like, "Okay, then here we go."
Was it a hard process for you?
It was very, very hard. I thought it was gonna be like baking the cake, like read the recipe. No, it was. It took a lot of research, a lot of time.
I bet, and it's like I see a lot of people like, you know, pop up with it and y'all make it look easy. But I can imagine, I was like, I don't think you have to do the lie or just the right amount. It can't be too much. I'm sure it's a lot of
it. It's like you gotta find the right wax, the right wick, the right oil, the right container. Like, it's a lot.
And that's one thing I noticed about y'all. So this is her, this is
pineapple.
Look, I keep trying to say you want to put another one over there. I was trying to get to. But this is pineapple sage, y'all. It has, I can't even describe the smell, but if you look in here, you can see the little flakes and everything in here. It just gives it a really, really like appearance. but the container she has it in, y'all know I'm like one of those hippie girls, and so it's just, it goes so good, especially with all of it. Do you change it up?
I do right now. I have pumpkin vanilla pie, and I have caramel.
So who's candles are better? That's the Body Works.
Of course.
All right, so where are you located out of?
I live in Charlotte, but I'm born and raised in Florence, South Carolina, so I'm here a lot. I'm back and forth a lot. I probably live in Charlotte 2 weeks out of the month, and here 2 weeks out of the month.
Okay, and where do you want this business to take you?
I would love to have my own boutique. That's the goal. That's the dream.
So when you say boutique, you just want a candle boutique or like an overall boutique?
No. So what I do is I do candle and cocktail parties. But I forgot about that part. So I come to you if you want to have a girls' night, date night,
right,
mommy and me night, and we make our own candles and have food, drinks, music. For the month of October, I'm already booked for 3 days. But yeah, you can find all the information on my website, queenlegacyllc.com.
Y'all hear that? Yeah, she comes to you, you make candles, and it sounds like
it's kind of like, you know, everybody's ready to paint and silk. So I want to like candles and cocktails.
I love that. So creative.
So this is why I tell business owners, I'm like, you guys are creative. You just found a way to make money.
And I love that you are expanding it outside of candles, which is already impressive enough. But just the idea, my eyes were like, I can imagine that being a whole vibe. Like,
I had my first pop-up shop was August 29th, and did a pop-up shop where local vendors came, you know, they sold their products. And then at night, I did a ladies' night and sold out. They made their own candles, and we had DJs, music, food, drink, and it sold out.
That is so amazing. So you said that you have another one coming up here on December 11th. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yes, I'm going to be the same vibe. We'll have a live DJ. We'll have Black Music Bingo hosted by Kiara Wilson. She's in Charlotte. We'll have our host, she's a blogger. Her name is Rika Delay. We'll have food, music, and at the end of the night, each lady will make their own 16-ounce candle. And this again is December the 11th. At 6 p.m., 1524 Siesta Drive.
I would love to come.
You have to come.
Oh my gosh, I thank you so much for inviting me. You are such a bright spirit, and I just want to encourage you to like keep going, because this is amazing. I don't see anybody else doing it quite like this.
Thank you.
Good talking to you. I'm going to be back over there.
All right, thank you.
All right, everybody, we're back here with Miss Diana, and she is the owner of MILF, all right? So I know what y'all thinking. Get y'all little minds out of the gutter. It stands for Mom Instructed Liberated Fitness, and so we're going to get into what that means for you.
Okay. Well, MILF, I started that because I'm a mother, and also because I am outspoken, and you know, I wanted to start the fire, so I used MILF as my letters. And so, basically, it's just me, another one of the coaches that I have, and we actually teach other women how to use their home equipment and do workouts without going to the gym. We teach weight loss. I'm a holistic wellness coach, so
okay.
I teach you how to lose weight without the, you know, the extra
supplements and all that stuff.
Supplements and things like that. I also do pain management, weight loss. That's just basically it. So it's just like a big community of strong women that's outspoken and just love helping other moms do other great things.
I love that so much. I'm sorry, I got choked up a little bit. I had drink something else. They got me, but you specifically said you go and you teach women how to use equipment, or specifically in their home. Was that something that came about trying to get
wellness? Well, what happened was I started in health and wellness through Total Life Changes. So I joined them, and I was losing weight, but gaining it back, and losing weight and gaining it back. Then in the gym, I was like, I was at the gym, then coronavirus came. pain. I can't really go to the gym, but I had already basically knew how to do, you know, at home workouts and stuff like that because of my past. But so I decided to kind of just get together with some people that I knew, and we just put it together, and we just came up with that. And so basically, what we do is our workout is cool. I teach cool workout.
Oh, and it's such a good core workout.
I love the jump rope.
Oh, jump rope. Yeah. Jump rope to have your knees burnt.
Yes, ma'am. And also, like, I do the cans. We incorporate it with the cans.
Okay.
And
weight, yeah.
And stuff like that. So we work out Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, off on Thursday, then work out again on Friday. And I have, like, a Facebook group where that's where we work out. That's all the community.
Uh-huh. And that's just makes sense. Oh my gosh, that sounds amazing. The fact that you took something from your own experience and you tailored it to moms, but to women overall, I feel like, oh, I have to think about things, think about having to be cute and having to do it, and weight loss being the only goal. But you also mentioned wellness. How do you feel like you incorporate wellness in your
culture? Because it's not always about wellness. You know what I mean? It's just basically, it's about being healthy. So I teach mindset, meditation. Like I told you, I'm a holistic coach. So essential oils, you know, different type of, just different stuff, natural things that'll help you on your journey, other than doing it the
old fashioned.
You know what I mean?
The cheap way.
Yeah. You know, the old fashioned way. You know, it's to me, I'm what you call a flower child. I've always been. Yes. So you know what I mean? So I'm real in tune with myself and the earth and just helping people. Yeah. So I just felt like that's me doing that would be my way to give back.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then I did it in a way that it don't cost much either. So it's like $35 for a month.
That's cheaper than...
Yeah. I mean, all you got to do...
Look, but that don't include all that.
You know what I'm saying? For that little $35 you get to be in the Facebook group, I do personalized workout. I got a coaching app, so I talk to you through coaching app. So it's pretty cool.
So what did you say something about not only being weight loss, but clearly I'm on the thinner side of things. See, but I'm one of those people that, you know, I have the gym membership and I don't go, you know, so I'm getting money taken out of my account, and I don't know, because it's just like, when I get there, sometimes you feel so overwhelmed with the equipment, and then you're kind of doing the same thing over and over again, and you're not really building up the muscles you need to. So I feel like this would be something that I can really do for myself, because like you said, wellness is the whole body today, and I'm someone, like you said, I need that meditation with that, the affirmations. I like to know all the other things that come out with my workout, what I eat, and, you know, all this kind of stuff. So I appreciate right here that I know there are a lot of girls out there. If you're in the area, please check it out. Go ahead and plug your social so they know where to find you.
I was about to say, you know, I'm not in the area coach. I'm for lab. So like, you can basically find me at linktree.com/Diana Brown. Sorry. Or on Facebook at Coach Diana Brown, and on Instagram, Get Fit with Coach D, and on TikTok, Coach D.
What are you doing on TikTok?
Oh, I be dancing on TikTok. Look, my little daughter is teaching me how to do a little TikTok. So I'm getting used to the camera thing and all that stuff, and being on the live on Facebook and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's becoming a part of me.
Mm-hmm.
Slowly but surely.
Me with this too.
You on the podcast.
But Miss Diana Brown, I appreciate you. Thank you. Very much helpful information. And I wish you the best in your business. Keep going.
Thank you. I wish you the best too.
Of course. And I'm going to be back down there to harass you.
That's what I was saying. We got to keep in touch too.
All right, Gilbert, we are here with business owner. This is Toby, creative genius. They are the owner of Color to 18. And I want y'all just to take a second. I don't know if y'all can read it, but this is energy, because that's what we do. Okay, honey.
And we gotta talk about this hat, so we can't say anything else. What did you do to
big girls are in. Girls are in, period. So when you're giving that energy, you just gotta let people know that's what you're giving.
You gotta it's giving what's supposed to have game, honey.
Yes, it's giving it.
I'm sorry, y'all. Don't worry about it. I'm going to cut this part out. But I've been told that there's a such thing as good energy. Is that true?
Yes.
That was fast.
100%. It is. Because if it's not giving, it's going to tell you it's not giving.
It's going to tell you.
Just from how it looks on the outside.
Oh, God. So, all jokes aside, awesome business. I got some tops, too. I've got to pull those out. What made you start on the journey?
I've always been very artistic, and my father passed away last year in February, and he always used to tell me, like, don't let your gifts fall by the wayside. So I took that energy and I put it into creating what people love. People love one of one pieces. People love custom. Oh, I got this and you don't got it. So all of my pieces are individual. You'll never get two things from me that will be the same.
I didn't know that. So nobody else can get my hat.
Nobody else will have that hat.
Listen, and I already know, like, when I work around my friends, they're gonna be asking. I'm
well,
like,
I'm
sorry.
I take orders, I ship. I'm out of Charleston, but I'm always in Columbia. So definitely, I ship anywhere in the world. I ship as far as California, so anywhere.
Wow. I love that. So, who are you? Where do you want your business to go?
I really want to open a storefront. That's my dream. But I just don't want your original storefront. I want to be able to have a storefront business where I have spaces for other aspiring artists to be able to come and set up and not have to worry about paying that food rent or worry about like paying to go set up here or paying to set up there. I want to give that energy that we can all build together. When you get on top, you know who put you on, so we there together.
I heard that. We can all build together, okay? And that is what this series is about. So I love that you already have that mentality, because so often we kind of get stuck into our ways. We don't want to network. We don't want to help each other. And it's just, even an event like this, I love how we can come together. We can talk about what we're doing, and support each other, and hopefully get a continuing year after this event is over. For you, how do you see yourself getting to that story?
Like you said, networking. Just make sure I have my presence out there. Making sure I do these events, support other small businesses, because you support them, they will always give love and support you. So just build everybody up how they build me up.
Yeah. Awesome. I thank you so much. Anything else? Any other events you have coming up on your own, or anything, any merchandise that you have that is new to your
Yes, I have more hats now, and of course I'm doing more hoodies because the season is changing. So definitely Color 218 merch is going to be available for order. Y'all can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Color 218, that's spelled with a K.
K-U-L-O-R.
You can follow me on all social media platforms. I'm on TikTok. Definitely all my new merch is dropped. That drops up every week.
You are awesome. Like, really, seriously, keep doing what you're doing. I love this hat. I love your merchandise.
Thank you.
Like, if you can tell, it's that one of a kind, custom made. You put your heart into it, and I can see it going so far. So thank you so much for sitting down with us.
Thank you.
Hey, what's up, Builders? We're back again with Mr. Tremay Rush. And he is the owner of Rush Fit. These drinks are so good. And it's like an energy boost. He has several different ones. I think it lays them all of them off the windows.
Yes. Well, some I kind of cheat a little bit. I'm not faithful to Marvel. I do have some DC there. I got a Super Dad and a Wonder Woman.
Oh, you did ask me if I wanted the Wonder Woman. What's the
Batman is next. Batman is next. Batman is coming in. I gotta make sure we get, you know, talking and get out there, because he's a very good businessman. So I gotta make sure.
I love that. I have Black Panther. which is kind of like a phrase and some other mixture. What are you doing? Pineapple. You know what's something? I put up to my friend on one.
Well, there was a store in Orangeburg that I went by. It says Prime Nutrition, so I went to go by there. And even though I mentioned I'm trying to get healthy, when I went there, I tried their tea, and then I tried their lift, which was what you had. I said, tea with the lift. And I just got interested because I wanted an alternative from sodas and other energy drinks that were fresh and healthy for you. And everything was sugar free. So basically, it gives you the energy of it without the dropping jitters. So I want to help you.
You've done an amazing job. Like, once I tasted it, and I was good, you told me that it could be coffee. I was back to school Monday, and that's going to be a whole day. So I definitely believe something to pick you up in the morning. But then when you said it was no sugar, usually you hear me sugar is like bland, it's not really sweet. I would have known that if you not told me, like, literally, it tastes like food. But the food is not the one filled with sugar. It tastes like a juice of some kind. You've done amazing. How long did it take you to perfect
When I first started, it took me like a month to really get it where I can do it without making it like second nature. So, of course, I tried it myself and my kids. And so, we're like, they loved it.
Yes. So, you got a kid that's a baby. How should I have given you
those? I don't give it to you, the kids, but it's about teenagers. I do make it without the work for children. That's not my secret. Well, I eventually would like to have a gym or a private studio where customers come in. I would like to have a bar. I would like to have a store that would like to sell nutrition. I also bottle these things. So I would like to ship them and sell them online. Or hire people who want to get access to them. But the ultimate dream is to make my atmosphere more fit. Rush fit.
I love that. Rush fit. You guys, please go check it out. Are you on live social media?
I am.
Please find me.
Facebook, Robert Tremaine Rush, or you can look up Rush Fit Club. Also, Instagram, I'm on Snap.
Snapchat? I ain't even seen you on
Snapchat. My kids say, Daddy, get off Snap. Daddy, you messed it up for us. I'm on Snap. I guess I'm
Google me, baby, okay?
Google me. I'm also a Zumba fit instructor.
I love Zumba. Where did you do that?
Here in Anthony,
the big city.
Big city.
I mean, you know, anything in uptown kind of street.
It is. We actually get the sound of it now.
Well, that's amazing, though. We appreciate what you do. I think you are so cute. Honestly, I came here, I got like 2 or 3 hours to sleep. I was talking to her all night. The history has been holding me in. Seriously. I don't feel jittery. I just feel like
Don't have the jitters, and you'll come down slow. You want to know what's going
on. That's awesome. I appreciate you for talking to me. I'll be back down there to bother you before you leave. Hey, builders. We are here with Mr. Bill Cash. He is the owner, creator, I think we were AYS studio here in South Carolina. We're having this lovely event. Please tell us how you conceptualize having a studio to this magnitude.
Oh man, I just want to say congratulations. I'm glad this is me. I remember when I was coming up 3 years ago, I needed a place to shoot. Wasn't instead of being outside all the time, I wanted to be inside somewhere that was hard to find a studio. So I said, hey, we drink my home. I didn't have any events there, and I was always with the squad out.
I love that. That's what this series is about, right? It's amazing. We create space for ourselves to grow up. That's since you've been in this business, what are the highlights and what are the things that you enjoy the most about having your own studio?
Just being able to create whatever I want. That's a highlight. And then still my clients. The biggest thing to see is smile on my clients' faces. That's the biggest thing. It's funny, you know, the couple salary going away. Some of the videos are asking clients.
Oh, wow. That makes sense.
And actually, there's some of the vendors' family, but actually, my clients as well. So it's kind of cool. So it's like, they kind of double dipping. So they came in to get their photos and they back in or something.
Right.
So it's pretty cool.
So it's kind of like your studio here at this location.
It is one of those things that works out for being
to help that community
create.
What are you seeing?
Next few years, I'm actually trying to move forward. So this is the first location, not like the test location.
Start a home,
correct. So I plan on reaching off years, Greenville, and then also to Charlotte, to do something like that.
Right. Now, a lot of these studios have those different moves, and they already have like things, Green Bay, stuff like that. Is that something that you, I see some stuff going back that we are done with that you're working for?
Definitely not. It's not really suited. They call it self-heroes or something. Like they're cool, but you can't do what you want to do in that space. So here, if I'm going to say it, a couple of weeks I'm having a big show. So one room will look like a doctor's office. Another room will look like the gym. Then we got another section. Mike likes that. So you're able to come here and basically turn into whatever you want. Right. So three or four things. They can be those three or four things in this particular space. Versus whatever they have in three days.
But that makes so much sense. You make a great point having this kind of standard client as opposed to being fixed, whatever scene is happening.
Correct, and like I said, it's not just all photo stuff. I got a big green screen up there on the wall, all the lighting that you need. So, like, come in, do a big green screen videos, like, whatever.
I've never heard that before.
Yes, it's actually called a chroma key. It's actually key, and something else. So you have the green screen and also the blue is mostly used for So all the lighting, all that stuff is used to do with the
camera. Just come here with yourself and your camera, y'all. So make sure that you please come and check out AYSU at your service, because that's what you do. And it makes sense based on everything you said, like the whole brand is going together. I love to see so many black data.
First, I'd like to thank you for having me on. That's the first thing. Thank you for coming out today and doing what you've been giving us, you know, a fight.
Thank you.
So I appreciate that. On Instagram, BillCash_GHB or AYS Image Studios. AYS_media on my Instagram. Or you can hit us up at www.actionservice.com.
I'm going to be looking y'all in
this video.
Well, I
didn't
really know this
was here. Oh, I'm going to be looking for you. Come on through. I'm
going to
be looking for you.
I'm going to be in my room, you know, doing a little something.
Come on. Come on through. Yeah, we got the brass. Oh, see, you know, zero girls. I already know. We got the brass world all over there.
Yeah, I was looking at that wall already.
Yeah,
nothing doing nothing
with
it like that. Okay,
so
you gotta have grass
walls. That is what it is. That's the thing right now. Everybody plays like I go place, man. That's not even a bad form. Like it's real, like grass wall. It's real right now. And the better thing is, let me ask them. I think I don't have a cheaper. You can't see through that.
Look, and I was looking at, so I was pricing online to see if I could make some money. It was not gonna look like that. I promise you.
But you got to see it with all the flowers. I appreciate taking flowers to them. Like, I had to put all the flowers and look for some rich.
Thank you so much. And
I'll
make sure that you'll
do
Alright, builders, we are back with another awesome co-business owner. This is Miss Antonia Edie, and she is in business with her daughter.
Yes, my daughter is Janari. Yeah, she is camera shy, so I have to be the spokesperson, the PR for the company. So, yeah.
Mama the PR. I know
Mama
that,
the PR.
So, before we even get started, y'all, I got to show y'all my ring. Okay. Yeah. Antoinette got it. Hey, okay. I loved it. As soon as I walked in, I saw it. I was like, I think I need that. I was looking at legs, but I probably was looking at it. It's a brand, you know, I didn't have to. How did you both start?
Well, we both always wore a lot of jewelry. So I always, about 5 years ago, I thought about it. Just didn't know how to feel about it. And then came across this one day where all the information, the best $10 I ever spent in my life. And here we are.
That is amazing. So do you make this jewelry yourself? Buy it from somewhere else? Like, how do you go about this
package? Well, we don't make it. We do have vendors. I actually work with jewelers now. So we don't have vendors. I need to have vendors. They teach us because that equipment is very expensive. But I find more convenience for somebody else to do it because I am a working mom still, and I have 4 kids. 2018.
What you gonna do? Listen, like, don't crack.
I'll be 40 in like 3 years. But yeah, I have a 20-year-old, 18-year-old, 15, and 13. So yeah, so we still got a lot going on. So this business has been a highlight. I am from New York, so you know, that's our thing. So the big earring, that's our style, and I just want to bring something affordable to everybody and have the stylish at the same time. Most of our items are non-tarnishable, so some of them will last you forever. Real about it, we let you know what don't last you, what will last you. But in all in all, you'll enjoy the experience, and you like keeping memories for some people, especially like, you know, ones that are past and things like that. You can take a whole new experience forever.
Yeah, I saw on your Facebook page, and I saw I was looking for the Almighty, and when I saw it on your Facebook page, I was like, my dad passed away 3 years ago, so I'm kind of, but I need that around my neck, okay? Oh, definitely, we're here to create those memories.
You know, and everything else, you know, anything you want to put up, look at that view. But yes, we're definitely here for all your customized needs, customized earrings, necklaces, rings, bracelets, anklets. Anything you kind of want with your name on it, you kind of can do it.
So I can get Crystal on a necklace.
Yes, girl, Crystal double plated, single plated, you know, with a character, whatever you kind of want to do, be our Cuban links. You know, we just want to look good for our budget. I'm never outside my budget. I'm always going to look good on my budget. And that's what we're here for. We want you to look fabulous for your budget.
And you're wearing all the merchandise.
All of it. Everything is Janari Jewelry. You got solid gold too. You know, you want to pay solid gold prices, you get solid gold free. But yeah, everything we wear is us. You know, so we are walking advertising for ourselves. Every day, all day.
So, where do you want this to be?
Next couple of years, I really want to get my shop. I want to learn how to make at least a certain type of nameplates on hand. You know, after I have a staff, when we worldwide, you know, I love the local support. You know, we don't went out as far as Louisiana, Texas, you know, strangers. I love that. You can create memories with strangers. And they know, you know, they pass word on that it's the right charity. From people who don't, they never, you know, and I appreciate that all the time. So, we want to worldwide, you know, I'm real humble about everything, but I thank God for the expansion, you know. We started 2.5 years ago now, and he's been going.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you, girl.
Like,
got a long way to go.
I'm about to go back on the chair. Like, I keep thinking about it.
I like your
funny ass.
Thank you.
Nephew coming in.
Yeah, nephew coming in. Yeah.
But I appreciate you sitting down and talking a little bit about your business. Go ahead and plug your social so we know where to find you and where to
go. We do have a business page, it's Janari Jerry. We also have Instagram, also Janari Jerry. Our website will be available within maybe about 3 weeks. I've been procrastinating a little bit, but God told me, yeah, go ahead, let's go, you know, so it's time to go. So y'all look forward to that soon. And my name is Antonia Edie. You've also inboxed me on Facebook. We have a personal page on Facebook. It's Jerry Janari. So anyway, hit us up, inbox us. We open 24 hours, baby.
24 hours.
You gotta get every dime. We get every dime, you know.
Thank you so much for my ring.
We got all kind of stuff for different nationalities. Like, our races are actually like Indian accent races. So sometimes that nationality will see where the races are. I'm like, where you got that from? And I'm like, we sell it. So, you know, as a business owner, wear your brand. Because when you get around and you ask questions, you should be able to tell them, this mine.
It's mine.
Yeah.
Wise words. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate y'all.
Hey, builders. I am back with TJ and
But I appreciate her. I love what you're doing. Man, it's... I don't know. Sometimes I show up with her. Sometimes I'll strap out. Man, it's beautiful.
I think it's like, and that was from Rush Fit. Remember, you guys,
I think this is strawberry and grape. Strawberry and peach. Yep. And pineapple with it.
He said mine is grape.
I never knew that would be such a good combination. But I never thought of that. But I was thinking that for my juices.
So, what's your best selling product?
I would say my juices. Earlier, I did pasta. I'm just playing, y'all. Kids are beautiful.
I'm about to say, you got kids. You
but there's not no kids on my kids. Kids are alive. And then, you know, I was just talking to a guy. I was telling him, like, I kind of had a, I want to say come to Jesus, but I had a kind of talk to myself. I can't expect my child to be there. That he's not mature. So I found myself having to check myself.
Hey.
That's what they call
hey. That's what they call it when you become. And you make them all yourself?
I'm a one man.
Who taught you how to bake?
Let me tell you what my mama told me. My mama told me when it came to cooking. She said, if you want to learn how to cook, learn how to bake, you better get this kitchen and watch. She never like told me.
Or you know what they always say? The way to a man's heart is to his stomach. That's really true for women. So.
And you know what? Yes. Yes. Yeah, like I'm a musician too, so that I can't take that frequency in my ear.
You alright.
Don't have that. You trying to downplay my experience, dog. But that's what she told me. I'm pretty sure you didn't know everything. You didn't know as much as you know now.
I'm saying,
so You can follow me on Snapchat too. Because I use it, I always have a toothpick.
See, you ain't even being a part of it right now with toothpick. You can do it better. I'm sorry, you know I gotta get you hard.
She been, hey y'all, let me tell you before I go, man. She been riding me ever since she found out. I
said, play some words.
Oh, dang.
Dude, we don't play. So you just performed. They got Wi-Fi. How you feel?
Great.
You know what? That sound like the same answer you gave me when we were on our other interview.
That's how I feel. Great. I had actually just woke up.
Before you came out of here?
She actually told me to be at 12:30.
Well, I mean, but you did great, and it seems like everybody's blowing your music.
Yeah.
You got a lot of people that was just in here jamming with you. Like, I love to see when they're catching on.
I'm glad they was feeling it, because my energy, like I said, I was just waking up, so my energy, I don't feel like it was where I didn't want it.
We did good.
Yeah, but you came out there, you turned me up. Everybody seemed like they was fucking with it. I mean, they was messing with it.
You would.
Okay, great. Grown and sexy. What are you doing?
So I'm going to let you go ahead and get out of your hair. We've got some of these other vendors. I just want to say thank you, Julie, and highlight you again, because that beckons our music. It's definitely dope. It's definitely going to bang in the car, no matter what you do.
All right, so as we come to a close, this was an amazing event put on by the Splash and Sexy herself.
I try, y'all.
So how did you conceptualize this event?
Actually, Kim,
how did you come up with this event?
So just plain and simple, seeing everybody doing them and just wanting to be a part, and, you know, help other people get their businesses out there. I'm a small business myself, so of course I want people to know me. I want people, when they hear Shalom, I want them to know Pop-Up Shop, or you know, what I sell, and the same with other small businesses. So just literally wanting to help people get out there and of course be a part.
The perfect song just came on, because this is a whole vibe. I love the fact that you have so many, like, and the energy in here is just, like, really good. This crazy person I'm sitting over here next, like, Miss Antonia over there with her jewelry, like, all the personalities in this room, it has really been amazing this whole day, and I thank you for letting me be a part of it. You got to keep it going. I know you will.
I am, definitely, and I definitely appreciate you wanting to be a part. This was very dope. When I told people that, you know, you were coming, podcasting, like, they were like, okay, like, that's different. I've never, you know, seen that before. So, you know, I like to be different. And a lot of people say that we all like to be different. But, you know, like, this was different. I never seen, you know, a podcasting, you know, at a pop-up shop. So I'm definitely going to keep it going. Soon. It will be soon.
Well, we appreciate you. The community is better for this event. I know spent some money out here.
I think we all need.
Oh, we gotta talk about those cheesecake cupcakes you made, honey.
That was my first time.
Really?
Yes, I promise you, right hand. My first time ever making them.
Y'all, so she made some cheesecake cupcakes. I didn't have breakfast this morning. And so, you know, you think you're just gonna get a little something. Man, listen, I was over here smacking and everything else.
And when I asked you to let me know how, you was my first one, so I was like, Lord, this let K come out on the good side, because I don't know how these cheesecakes gonna be. But I ain't see nothing. I ain't see you throw away nothing. So I was very pleased.
It was perfect. And I just want to say that, remember, this is Shalom. She was from the original Creating Space with Splash and Sexy. We talked about body positivity and body shaming and all that good stuff. So go check out that episode, run that back, and make sure that you follow her social media. She's gonna plug it right here in a minute for us. Make sure you order from her, you patronize her business, because those swimsuits, if you have not really been looking and paying attention, please, those swimsuits are awesome. So go ahead and plug yourself for it.
Sydney,
go ahead and plug your social media for it.
So Snapchat and Instagram is at Shalom_Dinesha, SHALONE_DINESHA. On Facebook, I am Shalom Douglas.
Awesome. Well, this has been a great Creating Space. It's been different. I thank you for letting us have it. Until next time, builders, you guys know where you can find me. I'm Kantoinette, and you can follow me on Instagram, Kantoinette_theblogger, or you can follow the Let's Build Futures page, Let's_build_futures. Visit letsbuildfutures.com for all the blog posts, all the podcast episodes. And remember that this live episode will be on YouTube now. So you can just type in LBF Podcast and you can see all the great faces out here. If you have any questions for me, allthingslbf@gmail.com. We are out.